Solubility product constant. So a solid like barium sulfate, that is BaSO4, in contact with its saturated aqueous solution, the equilibrium between the undissolved solid and its ion in a saturated solution can be represented by this equation. Means if you mix this barium sulfate, right? And what happened? It's just break down into ions, that is Ba2 positive plus SO42 negative. Okay, it will dissociate, but it does not completely dissolve. Undissolved means the undissolved particles or undissolved matter will just settle down on the base of your beaker like a precipitate. So there will be a equilibrium between the ions of saturated solution and the undissolved solid which left behind as precipitate after the reaction. So there will be a equilibrium when we mix this barium sulfate in a saturated aqueous solution. Okay, so the equilibrium constant is given by equation. We know this thing that K is for equilibrium constant, means the reaction constant. So K is equal to product upon reactant, that will be Ba2 positive in bracket SO42 negative in bracket upon BaSO4, that will be product, means ions upon the reactant. Okay, so for a pure solid, the substance, for a pure solid substance, the concentration remains constant, and we can write this like this, means KSP. K is for reaction constant, S is for the solubility product. We used to mention with a small SP for acids A, for base B, for like so on. So now if we are talking about the solubility product of reaction constant, so what KSP will be there? So if KSP is equal to, that is K BaSO4, that will be equal to Ba2 positive and SO4 negative. So now we can say this thing that the KSP is the solubility product constant or the solubility product, right? Now let's just understand this thing, how we can find out the solubility product. So a solid salt of like general formula, the general formula is of a solid salt is MPX P positive XY Q negative. Okay, X is the number of moles of M, and Y, small y, is the number of moles of X. Okay, P positive and Q positive, Q negative shows the ions. P is for positive ion, Q is for negative ion. Okay, with molar solubility S in equilibrium with its saturated solution may be represented by the equation. That is, MX MY gives XM P plus. X is means the number of moles will write as the stoichiometric coefficient of the ion. So XMP plus Y, that is stoichiometric coefficient of this X, Y XQ minus. So where X into P is equal to Y into Q, right? So when we go this equation like forward, so XY, MX, XY solid gives XMP plus YXP Q negative. Okay, and its solubility product constant will be by KSP product, means M P positive, and this is stoichiometric coefficient will raise to the power like X, and XQ negative, and the Y stoichiometric coefficient will raise to the power like Y. S is the solubility product, means like it's just denoting the solubility product of ions. Okay, ions. So X will write X S to the power X, means the stoichiometric coefficient or the number of ion will raise to the power out of the bracket, and Y S means Y. So how you can write this thing? You just take this S out because S is common for both the ions. So X power X, Y power Y into S X plus Y. Right. So this X plus Y means S X plus Y will be equal to the coefficient the reaction constant KSP upon X square X X Y Y. So S, that will be S is equal to KSP upon X to the power X dot Y to the power dot, means multiply Y to the power dot upon 1 by X plus Y. Right. So therefore, the term KSP in equation is given by the QSP, means when the concentration of one or more species is not the concentration under equilibrium. Obviously, at that time, Ksp will be equal to the Qsp. K is the reaction constant of solubility product and Q is the reaction quotient. This thing we have learned previously in our previous topic. So at this time, reaction constant will be equal to the reaction Q quotient, but otherwise it gives the direction of the process of precipitation or the dissolution. Now, common ion effect of solubility of ionic salt. It is expected from the Lee-Chatelier principle that if we increase the concentration of any one of the ion, it should combine with the ion of its opposite charge and some of the salt will be precipitated till once again Ksp is equal to Qsp. It means that Lee-Chatelier explained this thing that, for example, if reaction is going on, right? Means anions and cations are forming from any compound. What happened? If you just increase the concentration of, for example, positive ion, what happened? It just attract towards the negative and combine with that. Means it just disturb the equilibrium. So if you just increase the negative ion in the reaction, what happened? It combined with the positive ions. So whenever we add some ions of in our solution or in the in our reaction, what happened? They will combine with the opposite charge ion and some salt will be precipitated because the Ksp reaction constant is equal to reaction constant. Similarly, if the concentration of one ion is decreased, if we decrease the concentration of one ion, more salt will be dissolved to increase the concentration of both the ion, where it will be again precipitated and at that time Ksp will be equal to the Qsp. Means if we, for example, if I take out the positive ion, it will disturb the ionic concentration. If I take out the negative ion, it also disturbs the ionic concentration. So at that time, you have to dissolve more salt to increase that ionic concentration. The common ion effect is also used for almost completely precipitation of the particular ion as its springly soluble salt with low value of solubility product from the gravimeter estimation. The solubility of the salt of weak acid like phosphate increase at low pH. Okay, the solubility of weak acids like phosphate, it will increase at low pH. This is because at low pH, the concentration of anion decreases due to the protonation. Okay, and in turn, increase the solubility of salt so that the Ksp is equal to Qsp. We have to satisfy two equilibriums simultaneously. At that time, we have to satisfy the two equilibrium condition, okay? And the one new word introduced here, that is protonation. Proton means H positive ion. Nation means like protonation means adding. So protonation is the process in adding of proton H positive to an atom or molecules or ion forming the conjugating acid. Okay, so how you can find it out? This will be explained by this thing. For example, Ksp of Mx positive and Nx negative, that means there is a reaction that will Hx gives H positive and X negative, and we know this thing for the acids. We used to Ka is equal to product upon reactant, that is H positive upon X negative upon Hx. Okay, so means product upon reactant. If you just multiply this with this, like if you just reverse this equation, then how what will you get? X negative upon Hx and A Ka upon H positive. Taking inverse of both the sides and adding one. You just take the inverse of both the sides and add one. What happened? Hx upon X minus plus one. That is H positive upon Ka plus one. So Hx plus H negative upon X negative upon H plus Ka upon Ka. If you just solve it down, what you will get? Now again taking inverse, we'll get X minus X negative upon X negative plus Hx gives F is equal to Ka upon Ka plus H positive. And it can be seen that F decreases as pH decreases, right? So the solubility S increases with the increase in H positive or decrease in pH, okay?